International Middleweight Championship fight. Emmanuel Quay versus Daniel Adoku. We're back to how we started it with a wait and see strategy. Overly cautious, that's from the two boxers. Good left, a follow-up, but Adoku tries to fight back and connects with a left hook, but it's still Quay who's trying to search for it. It's an open fight, three for all.
Yeah, that's it.
That is what I want to see at this level. That is the middleweight. That is not a featherweight. This is the middleweight. That is where you exchange punches. We want to see devastating punches. We want to see the boxers trading punches to each other. We want to see that intensity in the bout. We want to see fire. That is what we want to see.
You know,
and that
once,
is what in
for
this
once
round.
I thought we saw something, some fireworks in the ring. And the two boxers trading punches, you know, though carelessly.
Lightening up this particular round.
And the whole auditorium in raptures because, you know, former president of the country, His Excellency John Dramani Mahama, has entered with his entourage, and he'll be here to watch the two, you know, bouts we have left here. That's the world title fight. You know, it was under his watch that we had this edifice,
yeah, definitely,
you know, consecrated,
yes,
built and consecrated, let's see,
which has helped.
Which has helped the sport
of boxing and promotions.
He loves his boxing and he's here to watch the two fights. And that's good, you know, for the sport. The last time we had, you know, certain, you know, vice president, Dr. Mahmoud Baumia, also, you know, coming in to watch a boxing bout. Adoku now, you know, fighting his way. And he's been tied up by Emmanuel Quay.
Yeah. Rack six. Thank you.
It was
right
a jab.
The lights, it has seen some go off several.
And Quay still trying to fight on.
Why is this guy?
Emmanuel Quay, that is not the way to clinch.
Oh, absolutely. And his,
he was leaning on him, on his neck.
And he gets
the neck
another,
is dangerous. He
another warning. Adoku missed. And then good reply there from Emmanuel Quay to end this round, round three. Hall of Famer and former president, His Excellency John Dramani Mahama. He is in the building and giving support to Kavik Fight Night.
And roll it.
And this was the good, solid delivery from Emmanuel Quay. That's nearly days Adoku, but he still stayed on. I think a lot of activity in this round, and Quay deserved this round. But officially, has he done enough to win this round?
Yeah,
or did
Quay
do enough to win round three?
He did more than enough. He was aggressive. He threw a lot of punches. Few landed.
Round
even
four.
His defense was not much breached. So, I mean, effective aggression, which Emmanuel Quay displayed, and him that particular round.
Round four of the National Middleweight Championship. And still to come, we've got the WBO African Heavyweight Championship, Richard Nilate Harrison. I think on the IBO rating, he's among the top 10. And it will be interesting to see how far he can go. But today he's got another hurdle in front of him in Maurice Okola from Kenya. Inside the ring now.
Where did you get? You lean back a bit.
Emmanuel Quay versus Daniel Doku.
Thank you.
Waiting for some activity in the ring. Oh, good reply and a quick response from him. That came in from Emmanuel Doku. And Daniel Quay. Daniel Doku and then Emmanuel Quay.
I want to see ferocious punches being unleashed by both boxers. Emmanuel Quay and Daniel Adeku. Too many clinches in this particular round, even though, yes, clinching is a defensive strategy. But you do that when you unleash punches to your opponent and you want to counter punch.
Three, what's happening, Fred?
Or when you are coming under a barrage of punches. But in this case, that is not a situation. The slightest movement, they go into clinching, and that makes the bout boring. They need to continue with the electrifying intensity that they displayed in the third round.
And working on the body now was Quay, but a quick reply from Adoku.
Yes, remix.
No, Quay once again will try to connect it towards a left hook to the chin. And he ties his man up and into the ropes.
That is not good. And then that is why the referee, he has attracted a warning from the referee. You don't do that.
You know, still we've not seen the explosive moves yet. And Quay, you know, trying to go upstairs. Sorry, Adoku was trying to connect.
Quay is clinching in almost the least opportunity.
You know, making the fight boring.
Yes. I ready.
And this was on the occasion that we saw Emmanuel Quay try to punish his man, Daniel Adoku. But Adoku still, you know, remain focused. And you can see that we've not had a lot of activities in the ring yet. It's as a result of the two boxers, you know, refusing to fight at some point in time.
If you continue like that, the judges might end up scoring with a split decision because it's very, very tight. No, you don't see any of the boxers dominating a particular round.
And that's very, very, very difficult. Could be
round five.
You know, but we aim for round five. And Emmanuel Nkwe, the referee, and still there's something.
They should feed my puppy.
And his gum shoulder. I think you should have been spotted long ago by his corner man. First to attack is Emmanuel Nkwe. And still trying to take the fight to Adoku. It's Quay, but they tied up once again and referee separated the two boxers. You know, Patik trying to set in. Oh, good right hand from Emmanuel Quay. Still going upstairs. Adukwu this time round is attacking. And he knows he needs to maintain the momentum if he's going to win. Adukwu and possibly dominate the rest of the rounds. You know, become more active. That was a big right hand from Emmanuel Quay.
The two boxers seems a bit tired so far.
Yeah, what do you expect?
I'm expecting a explosion because it's the middleweight where you expect two boxers to display high level of intensity by unleashing a lot of punches, and the punches must have telling effect on each other. That is what I'm not seeing so well, but this is what the world's middleweight expects. And so if you are going to fight in a middleweight division when you have Triple G who lost to Canelo Alvarez, you have Sergey Kovalev, these are the boxers you are going to meet. You are talking about Billy Joe Saunders, you are talking about Rocky Fielder, and trust me, you need to do more. We need to see signs of such boxers being in contention to be ranked to be able to have the opportunity of fighting them.
You know, people think the knockout win for Canelo over Rocky Fielder is a fluke, but Rocky Fielder is a good boxer, trust me.
Well, you need to just experience the devastating body shots that Rocky Fielder felt. Then you understand that it was the artillery that hit him.
You know, for now, it's Adukwu who is dominating. End of round five.
Car number JC7513 can make get over.
Don't give me a while. Stop by 6.
Car number JC7513. Please go over to your car.
A while is supposed to be working, not seated. Anyway, say for you to take it.
Car number JC7513.
The organizers are hiding the gloves. Why? Why are they hiding the gloves?
Halfway stage of this fight into round six.
There's a lot at stake. I've seen the Emmanuel Quay's promoters really get into the corner and telling him, listen, you need to get this fight finished ASAP. As to whether he will be able to do that, it's a different matter.
No, it doesn't look like he's on top. Adukwu has been a very stubborn, you know, opponent. And there he goes, trying to work, you know, downstairs. But wild punches will rob him of, you know, some points. And he allows Emmanuel Quay to settle down for round six.
Book box sex are not landing effectively. They are not landing accurately.
What are you working?
And I've not seen enough power shots from this two boxer. And it has to do with timing. It has to do with coordination. And we'll be talking to Carloco about that. I've not seen enough coordination. I've not seen enough timing for the boxers to be able to land the needed punches.
That's worrying, you know, on our part, especially watching the game.
And having been around, you know, to monitor the sports.
So, anyway, that's what I'm saying. You push.
And Emmanuel Quay.
You are off now. You put it back.
You should have done it. Let's better.
By two.
Or should do better. Give it clear. Is it point deduction?
It should have been, but it's not.
But it happens. It's happened twice. And it happened Aduku again. I'm
slugging it out
twice
once again.
Frozen. That's why I've taken you off. Because it's working now. I don't know what exactly we're doing. I'll be open up the tick click pet over here, then the thing freezes. Yeah. And it happened twice.
And Umano Kwe and Aduku once again. You know, it's become one too many.
Yeah, I don't know why there's no deductions here, though. He's still wanting him instead of a deduction.
Get your mail. Because
maybe that was earlier. Yeah, but it's succession. Okay. In succession, in succession, you deduct
and
two.
And still, he's back. And connecting, that was a big left, you know, one from Aduku. Aduku still staying within range and fighting, taking the fight to Emmanuel Kwe. Kwe is in trouble, he's run out of sorts.
He seems tired, he seems very exhausted, and Aduku is gradually trying to get into his rhythm.
And another fight, interesting fight. Kanoko is nodding. We'll bring him in to tell us what he thinks of the two fighters. But it's now open exchange.
So Jana, oh!
It looks like you want to face.
So Jana,
all tired.
So Jana,
his legs were wobbling.
There's a lot of pressure on Emmanuel Kwe.
Yeah. Is that not good? Vimix. Oh, okay, Vimix. Let's see, bro.
And that was.
I know of EVS. I don't know of Vimix.
And Kwe came in by the big right from Aduku.
Coming out to four.
Also came fighting, but the issue has been with the tying up of the opponent. That's
yeah, and the way he tied the neck is not good. It's dangerous, and it's the reason why the referee earlier on deducted. But after that deduction, when you do it successfully, the deduction you are supposed to be actually deducted on two occasions. But well, it's all well and good. We hope that this particular round
you
put up some level of performance.
We're in seventh of the Shadow Tour.
I picked you and then you went black on a
National Middleweight Contest six. Championship High, sorry. And the promoters of the night, they are also okay. You know, behind Emmanuel Kwe. Daniel Aduku. He's been like a Russian tanker. He's very solid and strong. Aduku again upstairs this time round. And Kwe will try to fight back with a good left hand from Aduku. It was a nice, lovely hook.
Is struggling, he's lost ideas, he doesn't know what to do, he's really perplexed by the resurgence of Daniel Aduku.
Let's see what Kaloko can tell us in this round seven, you know, watching the two middleweight fighters, you know, Carl, are you getting frustrated with what?
Yeah, to be honest, I'm a little bit shocked and surprised because when I'm looking at Emmanuel Kwe, I mean, he's coming from Kavik Promotions and he know about this fight for a long time. So I'm wondering why he's not controlling the pace the way he should do. But all the same, this is boxing. So we're not finished yet. We're not in the round seven. Anything can happen, but I'm expecting Imanokwe to lift up his game.
You know, are you surprised with the way Adoku has fought today?
To be honest, I'm not surprised because I know Adoku very well. I know he will come in with the wild punches, and if you are not ready to answer him, he'll keep doing that. And he's very strong, he has a good chin, he has a good neck. He's taking a serious punches, but still coming.
And Jeff, it's seven rounds, and so far, who do you think is doing what you wanted to see?
Well, not really, as both boxers meeting the expectations of very good or prospective middleweight champions. But at least so far, Daniel Adoku has shown over the last three rounds. I've seen Daniel Adoku show very good signs. He's been aggressive. He's been throwing wild punches. Some have been landing. I've seen some few jabs from him, even though they've missed. And he's been making sure that he lands some good hooks. And Imanokwe, what he's been doing best is to make sure that when he's in trouble, he clinches Daniel Adoku in order to avoid being punished. So that is what we've seen. But Imanokwe really have not come up to counter punch. He's not come out to land decent punches. He's not come out to work on the body. I've not seen good movement from him. He's been a bit sluggish. And the slightest opportunity, he want to tie Daniel Adoku down. And that really has not made the fight that exciting so far.
You know, and we're just close to the end of this round. We've seen the signal end of round seven from the Bukom Boxing Arena. And the fans are in. Yes, just like how we anticipated. You know, they've come in.
See the young guy, young arm, enjoying how they are twinkling.
Racks on six.
Enjoying themselves. It's always good to be in a Bukom Boxing Arena.
Absolutely. And
we are very exciting patrons.
You know, this should be the penultimate bout here. You know, before the 10 of the year, I think so. Because on the December 26th, there's also another boxing promotion here. And that's how this whole project has helped boxing ahead of it, seeing back to back every month.
Raksham.
You know, at least we've got
forget
some
we've been taking it too much.
And it can only get
yeah, what's up?
I hope that if the next round we'll see more exciting.
Is it okay now?
From both boxes.
Okay.
We're into round 8 of the Shadow Tour. Four more to go, but it's been even so far. Imanokwe and Daniel Adoku for this national national middleweight title.
Daniel Adoku slightly on top.
If you say so. A good right and a left from Imanokwe. Adoku, aggressive and fighting.
Stop by two.
You know, so far he's doing two. The basics right. In this fight, I mean, I'm not talking about the basic gym weight, but he's doing things right in this fight.
Well, at least what is necessary to enable him win?
Four.
Can Imanokwe come back into this fight, Jeff?
Well, it's boxing. I mean, it's his attitude and his approach and the strategy from his corner. The instructions that the corner will issue to him based on what they're observing so far. I mean, it's possible. Look, in boxing, just all you need is one punch, and that is it. You can't be dominant. You can't be leading on the scorecards of the judge. One punch, and that is the end of the story.
Then let's see. There's still hope for Isaac Kwe. But so far, he's been throwing. And so it's a jab from
Adubu. Three on three.
And goes in with a jab, but misses with the right hook. And lovely exchanges. And the game is becoming increasingly frustrating because immediately they start fighting, then he ties him up.
Especially Manokwe. He seems so tired. It raises questions about his condition. Because a boxer at the middleweight division, we are in the eighth round. Your condition should be very, 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 very good. Because you see, the middleweight division, that is where you expect boxers to display high level of intensity through endurance. And so if you are a boxer at the middleweight and you are getting a bit tired too early, then it may question marks about his level of conditioning. And without good conditioning, the boxer cannot have endurance. Without endurance, you cannot have a good foot movement, because when you don't do that, you have a lot of energy.
That was, you know, a lovely right. You talked about a dirty punch. This could have been in. And Adoku will try to convince the fans that he's still alive and he's pocketed this game, you know, but it's not been easy with when, especially when Quay, you know, went in with that left hook.
Stop by four. Four.
Another.
This round, I'll give this round to Imano Quay. For that left hook and then a decent power punch.
Let's see how it goes, but so far we've had it
very even.
Should he roll?
Yes, go roll.
Eh? Kasak threw your head
comes, eh? We still don't know how this fight is going to end.
Eh?
We're trying to beat nature by
six. Focus five. Waiting on you, five. I'm waiting. Camera five. Oh, just pick one. Camera five. Ah!
And there's
Rax on six.
We into round nine.
Jerry. Which eye I deal with? You left it, you were not working there. So why did you go back again?
And Craig is. And then, have you been interested by what you've seen, Jeff?
Well, I mean, that's what we've been, that's what I've been sold to us, but well, not really impressive. But I hope that I've seen Imano Quay come back around eight. He did quite well. That left hook, and then I saw that straight right. So I thought he was coming into the bout strongly, try to get his rhythm. But this particular round, he's not been bad. He's not been bad. Look, this is a better Imano Quay than the Imano Quay we've seen the first seven rounds. And it's always good when boxer begin to get into his rhythm from this round, getting to the championship round and then to the penultimate round, if to go that distance. It gives the boxer good momentum and convinces the judges.
Yeah.
These are the crucial rounds that a boxer, when a boxer displays some high level of intensity and good boxing technique and ring generalship, it really convinces the judges that the boxer really is the best boxer for the night in relation to this bout.
Some say that's all it is to the next, you know, Juma, and that's going to be the big fight. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, nine out of top, we're waiting
you get a knockdown, fine, but then if you go the full distance, then we're waiting for that big one as with Richard Harrison Nidate.
Yeah, like I said, you've seen that Imanakwe is gradually coming into the bout. He's gradually coming into it. You can see that he's gaining confidence and landing some few punches, which for me, I think that is commendable. He was on the ropes. He was struggling. And when Daniel Doku was landing some wild punches. So for me, I think that it's good that we are seeing two boxers. One dominated the earlier half of the bout. It reminds me of Marcos Medina, Floyd Mayweather Jr., where Marcos Medina dominated the first five rounds and Floyd Mayweather started getting into the ring.
He went to sleep and then Floyd worked his way into the fight and then won seven of the rounds.
Roger and the father were angry with Floyd in the corner. So he didn't get to get back to work, son. And so that's what we are seeing there. I mean, Manoke is trying to bounce back, try to fight within a certain rhythm.
No, that was a fight. You know, trust me, that was boxing. You know, to play against a very, you know, rough opponent. Get into the last, you know, 5 seconds of this ninth round. It's over.
Roll.
And this was Aduku trying to, but the punches are there.
Defense. You look at Aduku, he breached the defense of Imanakwe, landed a left to the body. And look at it, has a good right from Daniel Aduku. Imanakwe's defense was really not in existence at that time.
I think he's been second best.
The trainer is talking about combinations. The trainer is insisting that you need to learn combinations. And that is what he has failed to do.
It's been, you know, mixed reactions to this fight. With all the fights we've seen, I think this hasn't really lived up to expectation. We thought it was going to be explosive in the air. This division, one of the heavy divisions, and also with the action, but it's not happening that way.
It's also a division where you see good boxers. Look, it's not a division that I've been boring. Look, we have Roberto Duran fought in this particular division. Sugar Ray Leonard fought in this particular. These are slippery, slicky, very fast, excellent reflex, good movement, good hand speed, and phenomenal head movement. No. Sugar Ray Leonard, do you understand me?
And
you have Marvin Hagler and Thomas Haynes who are prowless and punchers. And you have very good boxers in Roberto Duran, beating each other. So, yes, this is not a division where you see boring boxers. But we were very excited. Look at Canelo Alvarez.
You know, this is the Bernard Hopkins division, right?
You mean Bernard Hopkins, how he disciplined decision and pummel Oscar De La Hoya to severe submission.
You know, that was a good fight. A very, very good fight.
He taught him lessons. You remember Bernard Hopkins and Tito? Fellas Trinidad.
Yeah, Tito Trinidad also good fights.
Brilliant.
And also he, Antonio Taba, Bernard Hopkins.
My goodness.
One and two.
That is, but you've forgotten Antonio Taba, Glenn Johnson. Those were some beautiful, beautiful
fights.
Yeah, bouts.
That was the heavyweight division. For how many years he dominated Bernard Hopkins? For 10 years,
for
he
10
was a king.
Years, yes, king.
He was a king of middleweight.
Yes, and went to the light heavyweight. Yeah.
And then jumped up to light heavyweight.
Yeah, right. I mean, you remember the fight with Chad Dawson?
Oh. Yeah, well, boxing.
But Joe Kazagi with Bernard Hopkins was interesting.
Kazagi?
Joe Kazagi.
You know, but now we have Aduku and Imanakwe, you know, fighting. It's Aduku in the green glove, and then Imanakwe in the white, managed by Kabik Promotions, and they are putting tonight's fight together. This is the set of the undercards, and the main event is the WBO Africa Super Waterweight Championship fight between Patrick Alote and then Sharif Kasongo.
The two boxers seem very tired. But still, Imanakwe gradually is doing better in the last three rounds. Because it's a championship round, and if you are doing well in the championship round, the judges are watching. These are the crucial crucial moments. The championship round, the penultimate round are rounds that the judges normally. You remember Oscar La Hoya, Ike Bazooka Courting?
How did
Ike was leading
it
on the scorecards of the three judges.
Until?
Then Oscar came up explosively, round 11, round 12, and that was it.
Queen, you know, was waiting to unleash some combinations, but it didn't happen. And the referee had to break them apart. And it's Quay with an overhead shot. And he goes in again. That was good left hook from Emmanuel Quay. He's come back into the fight in this round.
Gradually getting into his rhythm.
And he has control.
And that is the time if a boxer has a momentum, it works for him. The momentum has swung to his side.
End of round 10. And does another round of some boxing.
Yes, Emmanuel Quay's round.
You have to analyze it yourself, whether you're enjoying this round. But yeah, it has been good in all so far for the two boxers.
Yeah, very good. And for me, I think that on my scorecards, Emmanuel Quay is leading on my scorecard. Split decision as of the 10th round. He needs to work the remaining two rounds. He should avoid a knockdown. If he doesn't get a knockdown, he continues to work like what he did in the last three rounds. I believe that Emmanuel Quay will win the bout.
And Quay has been fighting very hard to convince his bosses who are pumping in the money.
This is a life and death. It's very, very crucial. That is why Canelo had to beat Rocky Fulton. Messes.
You know, I just don't want to talk about that part because Rocky Fulton.
Round 11.
Anyway, back to the ring here at the Bukomo Arena. It's round 11, penultimate round. And there's a lot of optimism from the camp of Kabik. The dear boxer Emmanuel Quay will win. Or he's going to win.
Well, because over the last three rounds, he's giving him confidence. He's bounced back. You could see that he was trading punches. He was sending jabs. He was releasing some body shots, which something he was not doing in the earlier rounds. He was now the aggressor. And so it gives them hope and confidence that, look, our boxer is getting into his rhythm. The momentum is on his side. Let's hope that at this penultimate round, if there's no knockdown from Daniel Adoku, how well will Emmanuel Quay continue with what he has, the momentum that is actually started?
And Adoku once again was in action. You know, trying to unleash some body shots on Emmanuel Quay. Adoku trying to fight again. And tighten pressure on Emmanuel Quay. And Quay still will face him. He will not run away and fight. Oh, that was a slip. I don't think it's going to be a knockdown.
It was a slip.
No, not at all. It was a slip. You know, a lot of money has been pumped into Emmanuel Quay. They can't end this fight on the losing side. Absolutely not.
Well, the boxer might display that the money is worth it.
And there he goes
and
on that
attack. That is what he's doing now. And for me, I think, like I told you, from the way he started over the last four rounds, clearly, I believe that he will win this fight. Unless Daniel Adoku comes out with a knockdown. If that does not happen, I see Emmanuel Quay winning the bout.
Yeah, he's been very active. And that's what the judges will look forward to. Your aggressiveness in the ring. Your generalship also.
Now, Daniel Adoku is the one clinching. Interesting thing. Two halves of this particular bout.
You know, has he got that oof, has he got that power to still continue, carry on, especially for the final round, since it will be going the full distance. He shouldn't expect anything like a knockdown. It doesn't look like he's going to get a knockdown in this fight.
Well, maybe the 12th round, anything can happen.
Still waiting for the final round here at the Bukom Boxing Arena.
He's not speaking to the cops. Eh?
Final round here.
Bro.
And the fans are coming. I think it's a decent crowd. Once again, it was Pei who was trying to fight his way in. It didn't look like it was one of the nicest fights, you know, from the start, and it didn't look like it, you know, at all. But he still remained focused and he's trying to get things, you know, go his way. Madokwe Aduku has been strong and resolute in this fight.
Well, I mean, Imanokwe has bounced back over the last four rounds, have been doing very, very well. I've seen him getting to his rhythm, throwing some punches. Yeah, some wild, but some landed. I saw him working on the body of Daniel Aduku, and he was also very aggressive. So he really shown more activity as compared to Daniel Aduku. And the only thing Daniel Aduku has to do is to knock him down. If he doesn't knock Imanokwe down, Imanokwe will win.
Yeah, the gum shield once again delayed. Sometimes I see things in local boxing.
Unprofessional. That is highly unprofessional.
You know, international, you can never get
it's
this.
It's highly thing. Unprofessional. You don't do that.
There's a final round. Give your all and let's see what happens. A real test for Imanokwe and Isaac Doku for the national middleweight title. And so, and this is a 12th round, and we're expecting, you know, the sort of flurry.
This point, we're expecting the boxer to trade punches.
Yeah.
Because you need to dominate to win.
You know, but still, you're not getting it. You're not getting that feel.
What is Daniel Aduku bringing? Daniel Aduku must go for the kill. He must go for the knockdown. Imanokwe, what he need to do is to keep this momentum, get his rhythm right, and make sure that the consistency that he has kept over the last four rounds, he continues with that, and that will be more than enough for him to win.
That's a good one, you know, from Quay, and he goes in with another. And the right hand, he decided to unload that right hand, and it's been trouble for Aduku. You know, good right, and Aduku coming back. Aduku once again.
You want to go all out, a few seconds left. 1 minute, 5 seconds.
Yeah, more time.
There's a lot of seconds in boxing. If you really want to punch, you have to go in for the kill. At this stage, you go in for the kill. You take the risk, throw punches, but it must land.
Yeah, the two boxers are tied. And you can see it's affected their work rates, you know, their speed, their hand speed, and also their foot.
Question marks
as well.
Question marks about their trainers' conditioning. And how well are these boxers conditioning? How well are they conditioned for such bouts? It's a lot of questions that Kaloko must be answering. I have a problem with the conditioning, whether even the boxing trainers have understand conditioning of boxers for bouts like national title. It's a whole major challenge that we have when it comes to our trainers.
I don't think it's been the best. When this bout ends, we'll be asking Kaloko about his fair assessment, you know, whether this is some good advertisement for Ghana boxing in the middleweight division. You know, I don't think so. That's the end of round 12. It's over. The national middleweight title fight has ended here at the Bukom Boxing Arena. Emmanuel Quay and Daniel Aduku.
It's Christmas, guys. And cue ring announcer.
And we have to go for the final score. Who's won this bout? Mohamed Amin Lamte is inside the ring.
Very well, Ridwan Asante, Jeffrey Sari from the commentary position, thank you very much. We're still live here from the Bukom Boxing Arena. We're still waiting for the verdicts. But before the verdicts, ladies and gentlemen, let me acknowledge the presence, one of our own, a legend boxing commentator, a legend sports journalist who has been here before. Please, let's welcome the one and only Nii Anu Thompson. Let's put our hands together for him. He's over there. Nii, thank you very much. Let me also do the same to a Ghanaian boxer who defended his title for 10 consecutive years, 3 times world champion. Please welcome Berrima Zum Zum Azuma Nelson. Thank you very much. And let me also do the same to one man who loves boxing now. He has become a boxing enthusiast, the former president of the Republic of Ghana, His Excellency John Dramani Mahama. Let me also acknowledge the presence of some of our traditional chiefs who are caretakers of this land, Nii Adote Otinko II, Simpi Manche. Let me also acknowledge Nii Afutu Afraja the first, Nifu Makralo, and the Nii Nyante, the first development chief of Accra. These are the landlords, so we need to appreciate them. Now, the former Minister of Youth and Sports, Nii Lamte Van Der Poel, thank you very much for coming.
Yeah,
we appreciate you.
We need to do TV, we need to do FTA satellite, and for radio, we do DAB.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we have the verdicts. If you are happy, shall we put hands together for the two boxes? Great. Let me invite Mr. Rabun Dodu, the chairman of promotions at the GBA, to join us for the crowning of the champion. Let me invite the General Secretary of Ghana Boxing Authority, Patrick Johnson, and the second Vice President of the GBA, Mr. Ibrahim Nikwe, to join us for the crowning of the champion. Now we have the verdicts. Judge 1, scored about 115 to 116. Judge 2, scored about 113 to 118. And Judge 3, scored about 114 to 115. by a unanimous point decision. Ladies and gentlemen, shall we please welcome the new middleweight champion of Ghana, Ace the Bosca, Daniel Adaku. Now the crowning moment. The crowning moment.
Commentary and hand
you know, so it's
Stand by.
You know, good for Adaku. I think he did well. He did well to, you know, win this fight. Although it's going to be a bit of a disappointment on the part of the promoters.
Outro.
You know, and also the man who is putting a lot of money for this promotion to happen, Emmanuel Quay. I don't think he showed up on the night.
10 seconds.
And Adaku decided to do that. You know, we're talking more about this fight, but first, let's get inside the ring and. This how it's happened. New
Five,
champion, middleweight champion,
four,
you know, for the for
three,
Ghana
music king,
is Daniel Adaku.
One, roll it. Roll, Kofi. Kofi, roll. Go out. Take it, MC, Ranbeck. Ranbeck, take it. Go, take the break. Wait, see, he's gone out. Yeah, let them start up. Stand by for 10, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, roll it, roll it. Bosses. Bosses.
I know she has something special for us.
Bosses, I thought you were going to do the whistle when we were on break. No, we come back. And they are still not doing it.